Okay. What's up, everybody? It's your boy Tylen.
Tracy.
And we're TNT.
Yes, we are. Dynamite.
Dynamite explosion. Toxic TikTok. Toxic love.
Yeah, that's what we get. Toxic TikTok.
Love bombing.
All the way.
All the way till we die, man. Every day till we die.
For sure. 50.
I think, 50 plus.
That's well, what we're down for. To 49 now. So
oh, yeah, we is. Oh, shit.
Yeah, almost.
Damn.
Almost.
Yeah, we almost there, bruh. You know what I'm saying? About a year, and then we'll be one down. You know what I'm saying? 49 to go. That's how you do it. That's the mentality. That's how you do it, man.
Yeah.
That's why I love this woman. You know what I'm saying? She thinks like that, man. That's real shit. Actually, that leads us into our first topic of the day.
What is our topic today?
Toxic relationships.
Oh, yeah.
The word toxic.
Yeah, where'd that come from?
I have no idea.
Like, it used to be on labels of toys and stuff.
Yeah.
I don't think people have those labels.
Don't
like,
eat that.
Non-toxic. Mine would maybe say toxic sometimes, but mostly non-toxic.
Yeah. I'm sorry. Yeah. My shit would say toxic all the fucking time, dude. For real.
Real story.
Red fucking flag, boy.
According to the world. Different strokes for different folks.
Different folks, man, they ain't ready for that. You know what I'm saying? But that's the thing.
Some people ain't for everyone.
I ain't for everyone. What do you do about that, though? Like, I mean, as far as, you know, it being a terminology used for toys, fluid, just products in general, and now people use it for labels to label somebody, or, like I was saying before, as an excuse to leave or quit a relationship.
I mean, to leave or quit a relationship or to warn others to not go down that road, right?
Right.
Yeah. What do you do about it? I don't know. I mean, you are who you are.
Right. And I think that's my thing, like, with the whole red flags thing. You know, when people say, oh, red flags. And I'm like, well, that's kind of odd because everybody has red flags.
I mean, everybody has baggage.
Everybody has baggage.
That's what it was called back in the day. Yeah. Now it's a red flag.
Yep.
But we all have baggage.
We all do.
Different kinds of baggage, different size baggage.
Yes.
Some people have multiple baggages.
Yes.
No, that's not a word, but I only have one suitcase. No, I'm kidding.
I only got three suitcases. That's it. You know what I'm saying? But that's, I've seen a post one time, somebody put up a post and it said, The purpose of finding someone is to find someone that'll help you unpack your baggage. You know what I'm saying? Because like you said, we all have them, you know?
Right? I mean...
We're not unpack them, but just...
Maybe help carry the load.
Right. But I don't think that's a good excuse to not, you know, mess with somebody. I think that makes you shows you're a stronger person because you can help them get through those things because everybody has stuff and trauma and stuff that they've been through in life, and their baggages are full, you know?
This is true, and I think, though, one of the things, though, is that when you meet someone, or when you start a relationship with someone, you don't really, like, share your baggage with them
right
off the rip, right? So you're getting to know this person, you're dating this person, and then the baggage starts creeping in.
Yep.
Maybe not purposefully either, it just starts kind of, like, just dripping in. Mm-hmm. And the other person's like, whoa, like, who are you?
I didn't
know that about you, and I don't know how I feel about that. So, one of the things for us is we got that out of the way right away.
Nigga, all my baggage was unpacked. somebody told her all my baggage, you know what I'm saying? She knew all about the man, you know what I'm talking about? The myth, the legend.
I got told by people. But the one thing, though, that kind of helped me accept his baggage is that he was completely honest with me without him knowing that I got told. He came and told me before I shared with him.
Right.
Oh, okay. That makes sense because, you know, I heard this and that about you.
Right. But I'll tell you why. Because one of the things that I had as a red flag for me was women that didn't know how to listen. And when I met you, I've met women that know how to listen. Don't get me wrong. But when I met you at this age and stage of my life, it's the first time in a long time that I met a woman that just actually listened to somebody. You know what I'm saying? Like, listened to a man that she was interested in. Like, she listened to me. So I could tell her what the things that were going on. I could tell her the things that I've been through and not feel like I was going to be judged. I was going to have somebody that was actually going to use her ear and her mind and listen to what I was saying, and then give me her, you know what I'm saying, her anecdote or her advice, or, you know, just sit there and just be like, wow.
just absorb it. And actually, I'm like, I need a few days to process this.
I remember that. I was panicking like a motherfucker too. I was like, man, hey man, you ain't called me, man. What's going on? She said, oh, let's just go ahead and just take a little time. I said, okay, I got you.
And the one thing is this, though, because, you know, as a female, a lot of females go to other females with this scenario. You know, I met this guy, he told me this, he told me that. What do you think? Do you think I should move forward or should I not move forward? I didn't do all that. I didn't do no outside consulting. I just took it, thought about it, processed it, and made my own decision to move forward with this relationship with my man.
That's what's up. That's right.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And that's the difference. I think that's a big, huge, that's a huge difference for me at this stage of my life, is just to have a woman that, you know, had a conversation with me and made her decisions with me. And I did the same thing, you know. I remember that week. My boy, Coach Pat hit me up. Was like, man, what the fuck you do? Excuse my language. Man, what the hell you do? I was like, oh man, I don't know, man. I messed this one up, man. He's like, what you do? I said, I told him the truth, man. He was like, what? I was like, yeah, man. You know what I'm saying? I was like, I'm trying to see what's up, man. You know, but it's better because it's like we talked about this before. It's like, you know, you go through these situations. I think a lot of people probably go through these situations where you get into a start a relationship with someone, and like you said, everything starts to creep out. And you could be, you know, 3, 4, 5 years into a relationship before you actually find, you know, the 80. Baggage. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? 80% of their baggage. Just 80, you know what I'm saying? Because it's really hard to find 100% about somebody, you know, all everything. Because shit, I don't even remember everything unless I'm like just sitting there like, oh yeah, I remember that. But to go into these situations and not find out about them for so long is very difficult. But to find out about it, you know, in the first 3 weeks of being with someone, I think that gives you, it gives you the opportunity to say, okay, can I handle this person? Can I handle their baggage? And, you know, there's some baggage that you had to unpack with me also. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
That kind of creeped out, so, I guess. I don't know.
You know what I'm saying? But it's a blessing, because, you know, I know the person that I'm with, and I know that from the get-go, and I know no matter what, she'll listen to me and understand me, and she will talk to me. And if I can get those three, I tell her this all the time, if I can get those three things out of her, I can handle anything. I can handle anything. I don't give a fair. I don't care what it is. I can go through anything with
it. Yeah, and he's got big shoulders because he's handling a lot of stuff, but we'll get into that later.
Oh yeah, that is gonna be another episode. Yeah, that is. That's gonna be another episode too, boy. We got a lot to talk about. So, and this is why we brought this to you guys, because we have a lot of things that we've gone through and experienced between each other. Yes, we've only been together going on a year and about what, 2 weeks? Two week countdown.
Yeah, something like that. Maybe a year.
But I think we've catapulted. Our relationship has gone very quickly. I think love grew.
It's because you're a love bomber. Let's love get bombing. Into that term.
Oh, love bombing?
Yeah, love bombing. Like, it's
love bombing is dope.
It's negative, though, in the world.
They like, haters. Why? Because they haters.
Why? I mean, why does that have to be a bad thing if you love bomb someone?
Okay, so let me break down love bombing, what I feel. I sent you this. One of the illest quotes in love bombing came from It's a Wonderful Life. And your boy told his girl, he said, hey, what you want me to do? He said, you want me to go lasso the moon? He said, that what you want me to do? You want me to lasso the moon and pull it down for you? He said, fine, I'll lasso the moon for you, pull it down. He can't lasso the moon. Ain't no way to lasso the moon. It's love bombing, right? But to her, it made her whole life. To hear that he would go through the lengths possible, which is something that he probably won't ever do, but it sounds like he'll take to the ends of the depths of the earth to do it. So for her, it was like fulfilling to say, okay, this man will do endless for me. You know what I'm saying? He may not be able to achieve it, but at least I know that's what he wants. And I think that's part of what love bombing for me is.
Well, for us, it's different because we see it that way. But I think that on the flip side, people use it to get what they want, because we do live in a self-indulgent world where people are just all about me and my needs and what I want and what you can do for me.
Right, right.
So then when you get this love bomber coming in and they're doing all this stuff for you, they have a secret agenda, and that agenda then does come out, but for us, it's not that way.
Right, right.
Because we love bomb each other.
Right. Right.
And we're going to continue to do so for the next 49 years, right?
Right.
Yeah.
Right. But that's why, and that's why I appreciate love bombing, because when you love bomb, what you've done is, like I've done a post about this before, that's why I feel like words are more important than actions, because when you love bomb, you set a standard. So like when my woman texts me and tells me, baby, I love you, I want to be with you, I want 50 out of you, she set a standard with me. So now, she has to have those actions meet up to that. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you're in a relationship and nobody's love bombing you, nobody's telling you they love you, they want to be with you, you're the best thing ever, then they can do whatever and then look at you like, I didn't tell you anything. I didn't. I can do whatever I want to do. I didn't tell you that. You know what I'm saying? I say I love you. Oh, so you don't know where you're at.
I care for you.
Right. Yeah, right. You know what I'm saying? She know I love her. I tell her every single day.
Yes, we do tell each other every single day.
We talk to each other about love every single day. We love bomb each other every single day. And what would happen if we loved each other and love bomb each other every single day for the rest of our lives? What would happen?
We would get more than 50.
50. 50 plus.
Well, I mean, you know.
50 plus.
Whatever the good Lord says, because, you know, I'm not young.
99, boy. 99, 99. I'm making it though. I'm making, cause I got to. I love bombed her. I got to now. You know what I'm saying? I gotta be walking around 98 years old. Wait, I'm not
playing. He's younger. So than
me. Yeah. She, I'm her boy toy.
Cougar.
I'm her boy toy.
No, totally not my boy.
Oh yes, I is.
Oh, you are.
Oh yes, okay, I is.
That's one of the. That's one of his titles, I guess.
Oh, we'll talk about that. We'll talk about that. We'll talk about that another day. But yeah, what about this? What do you know about gaslighting?
I don't know shit about it. To be honest, sorry. Cussing, I know it's a bad thing. And I know people like try to make it. So they try to turn things around. They do something wrong and then they try to turn it around on you like you are the wrongdoer. That's how I understand gaslighting.
Yes, I've been through that.
And that's just crazy. I mean, you can't get to 50 with that for sure.
No.
Like, again, gaslighting. Who does gaslighting? Narcissists. Let's just get into that term, because everybody throws that term around.
Oh,
narcissists.
My God. I've never seen narcissistic behavior so blatant while calling other people narcissistic.
Yeah.
That's crazy. Like, you got people who sit up there and are all about themselves. Who one of the things I always have said to people is, the first rule about being a narcissist is you don't know how to take blame. So if you're with someone who never takes blame, never says, hey, you know what, I'm sorry that I did that, or hey, you know what, my fault, or matter of fact, one of the best terms in the world, my bad. If a person can't even say my bad to you, they are the narcissist. And them be the main ones that are like, you're a narcissist. You're trying to control me. You're trying to manipulate me.
And the funny thing though is narcissistic people, men are more labeled as narcissistic
true.
Women.
Very true.
But there
very
are true. Some narcissistic women out there.
Man, they bad, bro.
There's some toxic women out there that are calling men toxic,
man.
Calling men narcissistic. But I'm like, sister, you need to look in the mirror. Look at yourself. Because what you're putting out there, I'm just watching you, but what you're putting out there, there's how many fingers pointing back at you when you point at someone? Like
3, 4. You got a thumb.
3, 4. Yeah. So one's pointing at you.
Well, you got a gun. That ain't a gun. You try to light me up. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? But you're very, very,
but
very
three
true.
Three fingers pointing back at me.
Very, very true.
You know, it's all biblical. It's all biblical,
right.
Really. Like,
right.
You're looking at the sliver in my eye when you have a big old log in your
right.
eye.
Right.
Game recognizes game.
Right. True that. True that. And plus, never throw stones while you live in a glass house. We got a lot of glass house stone throwers, boy, nowadays, boy. People just lives as dirty as can be, but they point everybody else out. You know what I mean? Like, and like you just said, it'd be the most people with the most toxic stuff in their life, the most messed up stuff in their life, going through the most drama in their life, but point fingers at somebody else. You know, and it'd be like, hold on now, you ain't got your shit all together. You're single as fuck, been single forever, but you're calling me all these things. You might want to look in the mirror. And I don't think people do that anymore. I don't think, you know, people take the time to just look in the mirror and look at what they've done or what their contributions to the fault of failed relationships.
True.
And you know, I'm a relationship person. I want to be a husband. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I was before. I've been divorced from that situation, and you know, I'm looking to be a husband again. I've told this before in previous relationships to exes. I feel like some of the exes that I've had bad conversations with and bad toxic conversations with is because I would tell them, hey, look, I'm speaking husband language. You're speaking single woman language. That's why our conversation doesn't work. You know what I'm saying? So, and I think that's why this one right here got me locked in, because she speaks wife language. She talks to me as a wife. You know what I'm saying? Every once in a while, she get a little, you know what I mean?
The gangster. Woman comes out.
Yeah.
The hood comes out.
Yeah.
My alter ego.
Oh, that's right. You as a Gemini.
I am a Gemini.
Shit, we both Gemini.
I have an alter ego.
We both Gemini.
Try to keep her locked away.
That should be crazy. Well, that shit blow up. And we TNT, and we both Geminis. Dang! That's crazy stuff right there.
Yeah, they say that, you know, Geminis really shouldn't be together. I don't know it's astrology, difficult. But...
It is, honestly, it is difficult, but...
What?
No, Geminis being with each other.
Why is it difficult?
Because of the instability of the Gemini. You never know what person you're
okay.
dealing with.
Okay, but Geminis like that though.
We do
they
like
don't
that.
Like monotony. We don't yes. like boring.
Yeah, you gotta keep us entertained.
We're not boring.
You gotta keep us entertained.
Definitely not boring.
Straight up. Cause I show be like sometimes I be wondering. I'm like, I wonder what she gonna do today. I wonder what she's gonna pull off today.
What's she gonna write in the book today?
You know what I'm saying? For real. But that's, I mean, I love that. I think that the situation that we have is something new to me. I've never had a situation with a woman who's so pure at heart. You're a good woman. You have a very, very strong, positive vibe. You want the best for everybody. You know, it's hard to find people out like people that are like that. And I'm similar to that too. And I think that's one of the things that maybe attracts us to each other is that we want the best for people.
Mm-hmm.
And as many people as we can touch, you know what I mean? And, you know.
It's a blessing and a curse, though.
True.
For sure.
True. It's hard to live that life and be with somebody that lives that life too. You know, because you want all that attention.
Yeah, he totally does. I'm not going to argue with that. He totally does. He totally, yeah, he's the attention seeker. I'm definitely not that person. Mm-mm. I'm not that person.
I'm spoiled.
Because he's a June Gemini. I'm not. I'm a May Gemini.
I'm spoiled. My mama spoiled me.
I was the oldest, but he is too. So, yeah, his mom spoiled him. My mom did not spoil me.
Yes, she did.
No, she did not.
Yes, she did.
No, she did not.
She does now.
She does not.
She be all about Tracy.
No, she
be all everybody about... be all about Tracy. Everybody. Don't let see that Gemini right now coming out. She lying.
No.
That Gemini coming out because everybody be about Tracy. Everybody want to know where Tracy. Everybody where Tracy. What'd you do with Tracy? When I heard Tracy, that's Tracy. You're Tracy. Tracy, 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 Tracy. I'm like, I know Tracy. I got Tracy. I got her. You know what I'm saying? But that's
yeah, that was true.
That's what pulled me in. That's what pulled me in. Is that that's what type of person that she is. She commands that. And she gets that. She gets that from everybody. You know what I'm saying? Everybody wants to care for her, and everybody's worried about her, and wants her in her life.
Everybody wants me to take care of them. That's the thing.
True.
Yeah.
True. True. But that's not a bad thing either, though.
No. Because they know. They know the kind of love that I can give.
You're strong enough to do that.
I am. Yeah. God knows that.
Yes, he does. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's why he put you in my life, so you can come take care of the daddy.
Oh, boy. Here we go. Here we go.
Okay. So, you know, this is kind of how our platform is going to work. We're going to come and just bring you, you know, whatever topic that we have for the day.
We'll talk for the week.
Oh yeah, we're gonna do a daily, we'll do a weekly. You know what I'm saying?
For now. Until you guys, you know, right. Till you get followers.
Right.
You just create content all the time.
Yes.
Yeah.
And we'll bring it to you real, we'll bring it to you raw. We'll speak from our hearts. We'll speak freely.
You may not agree with everything we say.
Very true.
But everybody's got an opinion, so
yeah. You want to comment? You want to shoot? If you want to just ask us a question, or if you want us to talk about something, we'll take that.
Or do something.
Or do. Talk about that Gemini boy.
Nothing that would be on OnlyFans.
Gemini boy.
Nothing that would be on OnlyFans.
I got one boy.
Oh my gosh!
Thank you for joining us. Appreciate you, and speak that love.
Bless always. Us.
Holla.